I dropped my necklace. Hey. Out of my toe.
It's all right. No, I'm done. Oh, boy, how does this thing get open? Here we go. What are you gonna do? Hold it or wear it?
I'd like to wear it, please.
All right. May I? Go. All right, yeah. I'm getting it. It's a little thing, but I'm gonna do it here. Yeah.
What do you think? We don't want dinner to get cold.
I gotta tell you, I haven't had lobster this good in a long time.
It's a real talent that I have, actually, ordering in.
Yeah. Is that a real talent, too? What are you doing? Putting a new spin on culinary art, or you just really don't like the lobster?
You caught me.
Yeah, I guess I did.
This is a very interesting moment because there's two ways I could go about this. And I could say, no, you know, Sonny, I love lobster. I'm just not very hungry right now. Or I could suck it up and tell you the truth, which is that besides that fish you made that night on the island, I loathe and despise everything about seafood. The smell, the look, the color, the texture, the fact that these creatures recently bottom-fed on the ocean floor. It makes my skin crawl.
Okay, do you want to tell me how you really feel?
Better than I was, though. At least I can look at it now.
I don't get it. Why do you make a meal out of something you hate?
Because you like fish, you know?
Yeah.
This is supposed to be top of the line, so... Where are you going?
I want to make you the best damn hamburger you ever had.
That is so good. I wish I wasn't full.
Eat what you can, don't worry about it. Thank you for dinner.
It's my pleasure, really. It's actually nice to do something for you for a change.
You do plenty for me.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Carly Benson, domestic goddess.
No, I don't mean just, you know, cooking dinner or making sure my laundry's clean. I mean, like, you make an ordinary day into something special. Like tonight, you know? You never know what's gonna happen when you're around. I kind of like that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I thought it kind of made you want to wring my neck.
No. You got a gorgeous neck.
Let me get this out of the way, because I know how you love...
No.
Dirty
see,
dishes.
See, you cook dinner, I clean up. That's the way it works.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, you're the boss.
Oh, I remember you said that.
Yes, you should, too. Oh, you know, Bobby knows that we got married.
Yeah? How'd she take it?
She was great. Actually, she was very, very happy about it. You know, she likes you, but you know that. She thinks I love you, and I'm just afraid to admit it.
Say what?
You are like a cat. What, you were in the kitchen 2 seconds ago.
Yeah, I was, but now I'm here. I didn't get the last part. Bobby likes me, but I what?
You didn't hear me. She wanted to get us a wedding gift, but I couldn't think of anything that we needed, because we definitely don't need anything in the kitchen. And
right.
We got towels for days and rugs and art and chairs and furniture. And can you think of anything you want?
As a matter of fact, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. I don't know.
Okay, wait a second.
Wait.
No, I need a second.
Whatever you want.
What's... Really? If I thought you really meant that?
All you have to do is tell me.
I want to be honest with you.
Okay.
Something my mother said. She said, Carly, tell your husband the truth. So, husband, here's the truth. I'm not sure about this.
This? As in...
With this, you and me, lovers again, so soon. You know, I mean, that's probably sounds stupid because we're married. And married people are supposed to be lovers, but... I don't know. I mean, God, I don't want you to think I'm ridiculous.
No, you know, but you gotta tell me what you need. Because I can't guess. I'm not very good at that. So just tell me straight out.
Okay. When you look at me,
yeah,
you know, when you touch me,
right?
Like you were looking at me at dinner time, I have this incredible physical response.
And you see that as a problem?
Yeah, huh. Kind of. Because, you probably haven't noticed, but I'm incredibly emotionally impulsive.
Uh-huh.
You know, I tend to jump to the next obvious conclusion.
Right.
I mean, anyway, obvious to me. So, you know, like with us, if we have that physical connection, then I start to feel like maybe we're connected in other ways, too. You know, like in the heart, in the mind, and soul. But that's not necessarily true, because Jason's told me that 100 times. You know, people don't feel how you want them to feel. They just feel how they feel. And maybe you don't feel connected to me like that, but I'm walking around with this wrong impression, jumping to, you know, the wrong conclusions once again. And I'm probably not making any sense, am I?
No, you're making a lot of sense. You're saying that you've learned something.
God, I hope so. Okay, look, if I make love to you, then I will lose all perspective. And... that's not a good thing, because you could say something totally innocent and really hurt my feelings or really upset me. And the next thing you know, I'm storming around, or better yet, I'm hiding in somebody's stupid closet dressed up like a hooker ruining your life. And I don't want to do that, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to mess this up, not with us. No.
I can see that. So... what do you need from me?
I need time.
Mm-hmm.
I need patience.
Mm-hmm.
I think I need to take the sex stuff a little kind of slow. If you think maybe you could get behind that.
Sure.
Sure. Really?
Yeah.
Well, that was easy.
Well, I'm not saying it's going to be easy, okay? But I can wait.
Yeah?
You're worth it.
Thank you for, you know, understanding.
So... am I hearing good night?
I think, you know, unless you want to see exactly how much willpower I don't have. Yeah.
I want to miss you a lot, you know. I want to miss you.
That's nice. I'll see you tomorrow. Tomorrow. Good night.
Wait. There's something else I had to...
No.
There's...